Hello, namaste. Welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bauna, and today I'm making the requested recipe for potato and drumstick curry. And it is aloo and sahajan, or also known as saragwa singh. And we Gujarati call it sektani singh or saragwani singh. So potato and saragwani singh no sak. Here I have the fresh drumstick today, saragwani singh, sahajan, whatever you call it. So I thought of making the curry out of it. And here I have some more fresh vegetables, tomato, potato, and onion. And here I have some fresh tomato, and I'm going to make the puree out of these tomatoes. And if you adding the whole ginger and whole garlic, then you can also add ginger garlic along with this tomato to make the puree. But I always have my paste ready in my kitchen, so I always use the garlic and the ginger paste. So I'm going to cut roughly directly into this cup here and make the puree. If you don't want to make puree, that's fine. I'm going to make this curry in a pressure cooker today. You can make in the open pot even, so you will have to allow it to cook. Now this saragwa singh, the drumstick, it takes a little while to cook, so that's why I prefer cooking in the pressure cooker. But as I said, if you don't have pressure cooker, don't worry, you can make in the open pot, boil in the open. Add a little bit of water. And now I'm going to make the puree. Tomato gravy ready. Here I have my potato, and I cut the potatoes in a very big chunks. The reason is that potato cooks faster and a drumstick takes a little bit of time. So keep your chunks, the potato chunks, big. And here I have the fresh finely chopped cilantro. Here I have the finely chopped onion. I'm going to wash, peel, and cut this drumstick. Here I have my pressure cooker to make my curry. I'm going to add a couple of tablespoons of oil into this pot. Just a couple of tablespoons of oil is just enough. And I'm going to heat up the oil, and I'm going to turn on my stove on a medium heat. And I'm going to cook this curry on a medium heat. You can peel your saragwa singh or drumstick just with a knife like that, and when you actually cut the ends, it automatically take out all the veins just like that. So you can peel like this, or you can use the peeler if you are good with that one. The oil is ready, and from my masala box I'm going to add the cumin seeds. Just a pinch of asafoetida, hing, turmeric powder, and I'm going to add this finely chopped onion. Give it a quick stir, and I'm going to cook this onion a little bit from my masala box, masala paste. I'm going to add ginger and a little bit of garlic. Stir again and let this cook a little bit. Let's check on the onion. It's pretty nice here. I'm just going to cook a little bit. Alright, the onion looks good. And now I'm going to add this puree that we prepared, the tomato puree. Alright, just a little bit of more water. And to this, now I'm going to add more spices. Here I have the red chili powder, coriander and a cumin powder, a little bit of garam masala. Give it a stir, and I'm going to add a little bit more water here. We need a sufficient water because we're going to boil our potato and a drumstick into this curry. So I'm going to add now this potato and a drumstick, aloo and sahajan or saragwa singh. I'm going to add salt just to taste. It already looks great. And it, you can see that it's coming to the boil. Now I'm going to cover it. Cover the pressure cooker. Now you hear about 5 to 6 whistles. But you will also feel the aroma of cooked curry. And so if you think that your curry seems to be cooked, then you can turn off the stove. But otherwise, 5 to 6 is at least needed. Pressure cooker has naturally cooled down, so I'm going to open it up. Make sure there is no air, so carefully open it up. Look at this. Smells so great here. Final thing, the finely chopped cilantro, dhania, coriander leaves. And look at this, looks great. Look at the color even. It turns into the red when you cook tomato, and I love it. The aroma of cooked saragwa singh or drumstick is so aromatic. More cilantro, and look at this. So what would be the option if you really want to make this curry but you don't have drumstick? I love another vegetable. It's asparagus. That's one of my favorite vegetables these days. I just boil a little bit till it gets soft, and it looks green, nice color, and you can add that to any curry, even to this curry. Just add the asparagus in place of drumstick and enjoy. So this was all about the potato and a drumstick curry, bateta ane saregwanu singh or alu or sahjan. Thank you for watching, and I will see you real soon with the next great recipe.